As Ramadan in Mindanao comes to an end, at least 280 suspected terrorists, 69 government troops, and 26 civilians have been killed in the month-long war on terror in Marawi City. Armed terrorists have forced more than 200,000 Marawi residents out of their homes. Philippine President Rodrigo Duterte on Friday says the month-old martial rule in Mindanao is a success. But Philippine Congresswoman Emmy De Jesus of Gabriela says the military operations needed to defeat the Maute terror group in Marawi City do not require martial law.
Hindi siya nakatulong. And in fact, ang tingin nga namin, magiging venue ito for abuse, no? Kasi lalo na sa generation namin, katulad ko na nakaranas ng bangis at lupit ng martial law, and in fact, personally, no? Naging biktima ako ng kalupitan ng martial law.
De Jesus was a former political prisoner under the Marcos martial law in the 70s. The congresswoman is also questioning the timing of the declaration of martial law in Mindanao. Bayan Metro Manila's chairperson says martial law has always been on the president's mind even before the Marawi siege.
The media counted it. 18 times he mentioned from June 30 before May 23. 18 times he said he will declare martial law, and so he did.
A few days ago, President Duterte apologized to the Maranao people for declaring martial law in Mindanao and for the devastation the conflict brought to Marawi.
I am very, very, very sorry na nangyari ito sa atin. Sana kung madaling panahon, you will find in your heart to forgive my soldiers and gobyerno, pati ako, for declaring martial law. Wala akong choice eh.
Those are just words, really. You know, if he's sorry for Marawi, then why doesn't he lift martial law?
On Friday, Malacanang said martial law in Mindanao is a success. It has prevented ISIS from establishing a base in the Philippines, and it has prevented the terror group from spreading outside of Marawi City. But Kababayans here ask, if the terror group is contained only in Marawi City, why is all of Mindanao under martial rule? Petitions have been filed before the Philippine Supreme Court to nullify Proclamation 216, since the armed conflict is only confined in Marawi and not the entire Mindanao. Don Tagala, ABS-CBN News, New York.